let's do check the problems based upon this work. So work, for the work we have the formula. For the work we have the formula, work is equal to Fs, or work is equal to mgh, right? So, or if the force is applied to the magnet, then F cos theta is here, right? So, these are the formulas. Yeah. Let's check the problems based upon this. How much work is done by a force of 10 newtons?
First one. Given that F is equal to 10 newtons.
Force is equal to 10 newtons.
Distance is equal to 2 meters. Distance is equal to 2 meters. Right? So, work done form is equal to force into distance. That is equal to 10 into 2, 20. Yeah.
10 into 2, 20 joules. Right. Next.
Next one.
Here I am writing the given data. Calculate the amount of work done when a force of 2500 times F is equal to 2500 times the force of 2500 times displaces a body through 100 centimeters.
Displaces a body through 100 centimeters.
In this case, we have to find out that work done. Again, work done formula W is equal to force into distance. So that is equal to 2500 can witness 25 into 10 power 2. 100 can witness 10 power 2 times centimeter. While doing the problem, I already said that we must check the units, whether the given system of units are the same system or not. So times centimeter, both are CGS system. So 25 into 10 power 4. That is equal to 25 into 10 power 4. CGS system work is F. But if we need the value in joules. So that is equal to 25 into 10 power 4 into. As I already said that 1 joule is equal to 10 power 7 arc, and 1 arc is equal to 10 power minus 7 joules. Minus 7 joules. That is equal to 25 into. And the bases are same, 4 should be added, minus 7 plus 4, minus 7 plus 4. So the value is 10 power minus 10 power minus 3 joules. Right?
Next problem. Third one.
A car is being driven by a force.
A car is being driven by a force. Of
force is equal to 2.5 into 10 power 10 newtons.
2.5 into 10 power 10 newtons.
Right. Is traveling at a constant speed of 3 meter per second.
Traveling at a constant speed of 3 meters per
second, then it takes 2 seconds to reach the certain place.
Time is equal to 2 seconds to reach the
certain place, and calculate the work
done. W is equal to. So by previous formulas I said that W is equal to force into distance, W is equal to mgh, the
force is applied to an angle. That is F cos theta and S. But in this given data, the force is given, speed is given, time is given. Then what will be the work done formula? W is equal to force into work is equal to force into distance. But here the speed is given and time is also given. By the formula, speed is equal to distance by time. Speed is equal to distance by time. Right? Distance is equal to speed into time. Distance is equal to speed into time. Alright. So speed is 3 into time is 2 seconds. That is equal to 6 meters. Distance we got the value is 6 meters. So apply the formula. Work is equal to 4 into 4 value is 2.5 into 10 power 10 into distance we got value is 6. So work done is equal to 2.5 into 6, that is 15 into 10 power 10 joules. 15 into 10 power 10 joules. That is the answer. A man moves in horizontal direction, right, having the block of mass 2 kg in his hand. Having the block of mass 2 kg in his hand, and with that mass he traveled 40 meters. With that mass he traveled 40 meters with an acceleration of 0.5 meter per second square. 0.5 meter per second square. Right? Then what is the work done by the man on the block during the motion? What is the work done by the man on the block during the motion? Work done is equal to formula force into displacement. But force is not directly given here. By the formula F is equal to ma and displacement MAS. Mass here is 2 kg, A is 0.5 and distance covered is 40 meters. So 2 into 0.5, 1. 1 into 40, 40. Right? So 40 joules is the work done by the man on the block. Right? Next problem, calculate the work done in lifting the water of mass 200 kg. Water of mass is 200 kg through a vertical height of 6 meters. Height is equal to 6 meters. Take G value is equal to 10 meter per second square. So mg means with this given data the formula for work done is mg h m 200 g value 10 h value 6. Right? So that is the answer. That means 200 into 10 2000, 2000 into 6 12000. That is 12000 joules. So convert this into CG system, joules to x. So 12,000 I am writing as per into 10 power 3. 1 joule is equal to 10 power 7 x. So total in CG system is 12 into 10 power 7. Power should be added. 7 plus 3, 10. Right. Next problem. A particle of mass having 100 grams, the mass of a particle is 100 grams, is thrown vertically upwards with a speed of 5 meter per second. Is thrown vertically upwards with a speed of 5 meter per second. Here the body is thrown vertically upwards. Right? The work done by the force of gravity during the time the particle goes up is take d is equal to 10 meter per second square, right? So here apply the equations of motion like v square minus v square is equal to 2as, so that is 2gh. V square minus v square is equal to 2gh here. So v, so since the body is thrown vertical upwards, the final velocity is equal to 0. There is a u. Okay, so v square is 0 minus u is 5 square is equal to 2 into minus g value. So g value is take minus 10, height we have to calculate. Clear? So minus 25 is equal to minus 20 h. H is equal to, okay, H is equal to minus 25 by minus 20. So minus minus gets cancelled. 5 5 and 5 4. 5 by 4 meters. H, height is equal to 5 by 4 meters. So apply the formula. Gordon is equal to mgh. Mass 0.1, 100 grams is converted to kg, that is 0.1 because 100 grams is cgs, so we must convert it into SI. So 0.1 into g value minus 10 into height 5 by 4, height 5 by 4, so that is equal to 0.1 into 10, that is 1, okay, 1, that is minus 1. Minus 1 into 5 by 4, so that is equal to minus 1 into 5 by 4, okay, so 5 by 4 value is 1.25, so minus into minus, minus 1.25, minus 1.25. Joules. Minus 1.25 joules. So while training for breeding season, a 380 gram male squirrel, the squirrel mass is given, the squirrel mass is 380 grams, does 32 push-ups. Does 32 push-ups. Okay. So in a minute, 32 push-ups in a minute, displacing its center of mass by a distance of 8.5 centimeters. Distance is equal to 8.5 centimeters. Right? From center. Okay, and for each push up, determine the total work done on squirrel while moving upwards. Right? It is the horizontal position. Push up we are doing in this way from here to here. 32 times in the sense. 32 times the squirrel taking push ups, 32 times in the sense, one upward and one downward, we will count as 1. Okay, so here we have to take the value for 32 times only, 32 times upward only, right? So the total 32 times we have to take it. So distance from here to here is 8.5 centimeters. We have to count for 32 times only upwards only, not for downwards. Right? So take the g value is 9.8 here. Take the g value is 9.8. So g is equal to 9.8 meter per second. So work done formula is for one time. Work done. W is equal to mgh, right? So here m 380 grams in the sense converting into SI 380 by 1000, that is 0.38. S is nothing but h. Distance is equal to h, so it is considered as h. Height is equal to 8.5 centimeters. So 8.5 centimeters, since m is equal to 0.38 kg, height is equal to 8.5 centimeters, right? So 8.5 centimeters we convert it as into meters. So 8.5 by 100, so that is nothing but 0.085 meters, right? And g is equal to 9.8, right? So 9.8 meter per second square. These are the values. So for one time it is mgh, but we need for 32 times. So work done for 32 times is equal to 32 into mass is 0.38 into g value is 9.8 into height value is 0.085, that is equal to, if we do the calculation for this, then we will get that answer. The answer is 10.12 joules. So it is equal to nearly taken as 10, right?
Next problem.
A man of mass 80 kg carrying the weight mass 20 kg, so total mass is 100 kg. Is climbing the steps. Number of steps is equal to 40 steps. Each step height is 25 centimeters. So from these two, you will get the total height. So height, total height is equal to 40 into 25. So then that is 10 meters. Time, how much time he took the time take is 20 seconds, take g is equal to 9.8 meter per second square, right? So by calculating this, apply the formula W is equal to mgh, mass is 8 plus 20, 100, 10 square, g value is 9.8, height is 10. So 9.8 into 10 power 3 joules. 9.8 into 10 power 3 joules.
Sheila has just arrived at the airport and is dragging her suitcase to the luggage checking. She pulls on the strap with a force of
190 newtons. Force is equal to 190 newtons
at an angle of 35 degrees.
Theta is equal to 35 degrees
to the horizontal, and she displaces the luggage to 45 meters. So determine the work done, right?
So given that cos theta is equal to,
that means cos 35, here theta is
35, cos 35 is equal to 0.8191. So Work and formula here in this case is W is equal to F cos theta into S. F cos theta 190 into cos theta, cos 35. Cos 35 value into cos 35 degrees into displacement is 45 meters. So 190 into cos 35 value is given 0.8191 into 45. So 190 into 0.8191 into 45. So which is nearly is equal to 7003.30. So it is the final value. So this can be written as 7 into 10 power 3.
7 into 10 power 3 joules. Last one. Right. A car covers a distance of 10 kilometers. A car covers a distance of 10 kilometers
distance is equal to 10 kilometers.
Right. And on an inclined plane under the action of horizontal force of
5 newtons. So F is equal to 5 newtons.
And the car is moving on a inclined plane. The work done on a car is
25 kilojoules. 25 kilojoules.
Okay. The inclination of the plane to horizontal is.
So we have to find out the inclined angle. Theta we have to find out. The car is here. The car is moving in this direction. We have to find out theta. So W is equal to formula F cos theta into S. Cos theta is equal to W by F into S. So cos theta is equal to what then is 25 kilo into 10 power 3 by force is 5 into distance is 10 kilometers.
10 kilometers. So kilometer in the sense
10 into 10 power 3. 10 into 10 power 3.
So 25 into 10 power 3 by 5 into 10 into 10 power 3. Okay. So
10 power 3, 10 power 3 gets cancelled. 5 ones, 5 5. Again 5 ones, 5 2. So 1 by 2. Cos theta is equal to 1 by 2.
We need the theta value.
Theta is equal to cos inverse of 1 by 2.
Okay.
So that cos inverse of 1 by 2.
So in trigonometry you get that values 1 by 2 for in cosine value, 1 by 2 is for 30 degrees. So cos 30 is equal to, sorry, cos 60 degrees.
Cos 60 degrees is equal to 1 by 2. So that theta is equal to 60 degrees.
So this way you can do the problem. So in the next class we will cover the topic energy. Right? Thank you.